Hi, I'm Dr. Philip Kern, and I'd like to tell you about our study on beige adipocytes. The aim of this study was to determine whether beige adipocytes can be stimulated in human subcutaneous fat using a simple surface cold exposure and also using a beta-3 adrenergic receptor agonist, mirabegron. Our goal was to measure beige markers in fat tissue, to analyze mitochondrial bioenergetics, and to do this in lean, obese, and in older subjects. We also want to determine whether a cold application will affect contralateral adipose tissue. Our methods are to first recruit lean and obese subjects, and these participants first have an adipose tissue biopsy at baseline. And you can see an example of an adipose tissue biopsy here. Here we're taking a biopsy from the thigh. We also take an adipose tissue biopsy from the abdomen. Then we apply an ice pack to both the thigh and the abdomen, for 30 minutes per day for 10 days. Shown here is a subject icing his thigh and abdomen. As you can see, the subject is comfortable during this time, and this could either be done in our unit or can be taken home and done this at home. This can be done at home. After the 10 days of icing, a repeat fat biopsy is then performed on both the iced and on the non-iced leg or abdomen. Shown here is one of the images, and this is an immunohistochemical staining of UCP1 from both lean and obese subjects. The slide on the left is the staining at baseline, and then the middle slide is after 10 days of cold on the cold-treated side, and then the one on the right is on the contralateral side. You can see there's a significant increase in UCP1 staining in lean subjects and in obese subjects, and it was roughly equal an increase in staining on both the cold treated side and on the contralateral side. TMEM26 is a well-respected beige adipocyte marker, and so we also stained for TMEM26. As you can see, in both the lean and obese subjects, there was a significant increase in TMEM26 staining, both on the cold treated side and on the contralateral side. Different things were stained with UCP1, and we were curious as to whether cells other than adipocytes were being stained. Since it is known that the beige adipocyte precursor cell is an endothelial cell, we stained with UCP1 as well as with lectin, which is a stain for endothelial cells. So shown on this slide, the UCP1 is stained in red, lectin in green, and the combined image in yellow. As you can see from the arrows, adipocytes were clearly stained with UCP1. Note that we allowed autofluorescence in this image to better show the outlines of the adipocytes. In addition to the clear-cut adipocyte staining, also there is some staining of vessel-like structures as shown by the yellow merged images, which clearly indicate the combined staining of UCP1 and lectin in endothelial cells. Studies on mitochondrial bioenergetics were performed. From the abdominal adipose tissue biopsy, we had isolated mitochondria, and then these isolated mitochondria were then examined in an oxytherm device to look at oxygen consumption under various conditions. As shown in the first slide, substrates are added, and followed by oligomycin to inhibit coupled respiration. After that, free fatty acids are added to stimulate UCP1-mediated uncoupled respiration, followed by bovine serum albumin to remove the free fatty acids and to inhibit this process. Finally, FCCP is added to stimulate maximal respiration. As shown in the images below, uncoupled respiration was increased after cold exposure in these subjects. Also, maximal respiration was also increased, indicating that the 10 days of cold treatment not only stimulated UCP1, but also stimulated both uncoupled and maximal respiration. Based on these cold treat experiments, we also wondered what would happen with a beta-3 agonist treatments. And so we examined 6 obese, pre-diabetic insulin-resistant subjects who received mirabegron 50 milligrams per day. Subcutaneous fat biopsies were obtained from both the thigh and the abdomen at baseline and after 10 weeks of mirabegron treatment. On the next slide, we show the UCP1 staining in the subcutaneous adipose tissue from a representative subject treated with mirabegron. As you can see, there was a significant increase in UCP1 staining after 10 weeks of beta-3 adrenergic receptor agonist treatment. And on the image below, we show all six subjects and show that there is a significant increase in UCP1 staining by immunohistochemistry. To look at other markers that would likely result from the beta-3 agonist staining, we also looked at phospho-HSL staining in adipocytes from the mirabegron-treated subjects. And shown here is a staining of PHSL, and we show that PHSL also increases in these mirabegron-treated subjects after 10 weeks. So to summarize, both a localized cold stimulus and a beta-3 adrenergic receptor agonist induced adipocyte beiging in human subcutaneous fat tissue. The increase in the contralateral white adipose tissue beiging suggests, at least in part, a systemic sympathetic nervous system response. Obese subjects respond well to both stimuli, both the cold and the beta-3 agonist. And not shown in these slides, but shown in the paper, is that we found no difference in response to cold with age, that older subjects responded just as well as younger subjects. So there's clinical relevance of these studies. The target audience for metabolic disease tends to be older subjects with prediabetes or diabetes. And these studies would suggest that these subjects may benefit from interventions designed to increase beta-adrenergic receptor signaling. I'd just like to acknowledge the funding for this study, and thank you.